Now, by a show of hands, how many of you say that those traditions have helped shape who you are today? Okay. Well, my name is Makadai Isalul, and today I will be sharing with you how a long-held tradition in my life has helped shape the essence of who I am. My family's...
Hold on 1 second. So let's go back to what I just said here. When you ask the questions, acknowledge the audience. And then when you go into you, there's a good way to create that commonality, i.e. we share that. Right? Okay. And then let's go. Okay, deep breath whenever you want to start that one over. Yeah?
So how many of you could say that you have long family's biennial trips to Ethiopia have helped aid the formation of two major passions of mine, poetry and fashion. To begin, I was 3 months old when I began traveling to Ethiopia with my family. My mother, Wena, moved when she was 17 to the United States to begin her college education. My father, Yuzalba Uol, moved at the age of 30 to further his occupational career. After becoming married and having their first child, my older brother, Jonathan, they decided to begin a tradition of traveling back to their home with their children every other year.
Mm-hmm.
Over the years, these trips have helped in my formation of sense of self and cultural awareness. Traveling to where I'm from has helped me connect with my roots, especially in times when I did not feel affiliated to my culture because of my status of being first generation as opposed to being from Ethiopia.
Mm-hmm.
So when the time came for me to write a poem about where I'm from in the 8th grade, it was natural for me to choose to document the countless memories I made in a place which I consider home away from home, Ethiopia. This leads me into my next point, my passion for poetry. So that first poem, entitled Where I'm From, opened my eyes to a literary world filled with limitless possibilities, and I was very encouraged to continue. Since then, I have gone on to be a captain of my high school slam poetry team, performed at universities and baccalaureates, and published a poetry anthology. Poetry to me serves as a creative outlet and form of self-expression. And connecting with an audience on a deeper level, the spoken word, encourages me to continue writing to this very day. Writing poetry isn't the only form of self-expression that stemmed from my trips to Ethiopia. And now I will be discussing my next passion, which is my passion for fashion and design. So while traveling to Ethiopia, I fell in love with the traditional garments worn by women's special events, also known as kebis. Designs and the colors used in these fabrics encouraged me to try and recreate some of those within my own pieces. So at the age of 10, I joined a fashion design camp and started to successfully create and design my own clothes and accessories.
Mm.
By the age of 14, I began working for the camp and helping other kids turn their design dreams into reality. Fashion to me encompasses self-expression, art, individuality, and confidence. So my style is constantly evolving with my age and the world around me. And I cannot wait to see what the fashion board and future holds for me.
Ah.
In conclusion, two major parts of who I am today, poetry and fashion, would not have come to be if not for my parents' decision way back when to merge their worlds with mine. Where we're from and how we're raised has lasting impacts on who we are today. So whether it be your long-held traditions in your life, such as mine, specific family members, or even favorite school subjects, there are reasons behind why you love what you love.
Mm-hmm.